speculation that a plan is in the offing to move the capital city of Nigeria from Abuja back to Lagos. Okay, let's go to our next story, our last story for today. Following wanton killings in Plateau State and rising insecurity in the land, the Pan-Yoruba sociocultural group, Afenifere, has called for the establishment of state police, even as it annulled the office of the acting leader of the group. This development was contained in a communique signed by its publicity secretary, Jare Ajayi. Afenifere expressed displeasure over the state of the nation, saying it was time to restructure the country as a means toward a new lease of life and better country. We couldn't agree more with him today.
Yes, well, number one.
Take the word restructure. Let's start from
Well, the word restructure, you see, we discovered that in the last 4 weeks or so, insecurity has had a new meaning in Nigeria. The law we have nearly the person to cover. It will appear as if they have taken advantage of that thing and moving again. Insecurity, we are not battling with it. Then you begin to ask yourself a question. For what reasons are these people carrying out these killings, especially in Jos and some other parts of the country? What it means is that if our security forces, because I know that Mr. President appointed new service chiefs, he met them, he asked them to define new strategies to ensure their security, because security of life and property is the number one priority of any sitting president.
That's it, that's
any
it.
Fund. And he has done that. But the thing now is that it will appear as if the team is being sponsored beyond what we are. The threat to security now is beyond the ordinary Nigerian. And that comes to question the issue of the fact that we have to know the issue of state police as raised by Afenifere is as old as the Fourth Republic. We have been on it since 1999 because of the insecurity. So it means that not only state police, I think we have to have a multi-level policing. Multi-level policing from the local police to the local government police to the district police and to state policing. Number two is that police officers that we have in Nigeria today, I don't know whether they are beyond 500,000. Let us start with transferring police officers. When it's done, we are going to restructure the police. Let us transfer them to their local government areas. You will see that people will be ready to defend their people. That is number one. Number two is the fact that National Assembly, the last National Assembly, ninth National Assembly, it discussed the issue of state policing. I think the President Tinubu should summon enough political will and courage and go back to that 2014 National Constitutional Conference that accepted state police. There's no way you can police a country of 200 million people using a centralized police force from Abuja. It is not possible. A nation of 250 ethnic groups that has not up to 1 million soldiers and policemen. So it is not possible. The best thing for us is, as a measure of guarantee the security of people, let us go back to multi-level policing in order to give people assurance. Because as it is now, it will appear as if non-state actors, I mean the bandits and gunmen, are much more powerful and have intelligent resources than the established police and military.
Well, let's digress a little. When a minister in the land, you know, last week said he was being hounded, that's in reaction to what happened at Ibadan.
Yes.
By powerful Nigerians, very powerful Nigerians. Mm. Are we saying there are people who are more powerful than the country?
Well,
we know what he is talking about.
Mm. Well, an individual cannot be as powerful as the state. But what it means is that there are powerful individuals who can influence state decisions, you know, who can influence the law, who can bend the law, who see themselves as above the law. And it's a reflection on the fact that in Nigeria, we have always raised the problem that there is no rule of law. The rule of law means that, you know, the president and the man on the street, the law sees them as equal. Not that because you are the son of an IG or the son of a rich man, then you are more superior than an ordinary man. So I think I fully support the position of Afenifere. And I'm happy for the organization because an organization that was set up March 26, 1955, not more than, you know, after their meeting in the home of Baba Awolowo. you know, in Okeado. Over 70 years. You could see what Akpadokun wrote about 70 years of Afenifere. And he traced it to that their first meeting, where 60 people were invited, but only about 8 people came. But over 60 years, that group has been the dominant voice here. But in the past 10, 15 years, that voice has diminished to the extent that it has lost its moral authority. And that's why you hardly read Afenifere stories in headlines, because it's happened to be losing touch with the people. Because, I'm happy now that when an organization realizes that it needs to speak for the people and it's saying the right thing, people will listen and continue to respect the organization. So what the Afenifere has said is the old song that we hope that the owners of this country that we are begging now to give us the police, they will not be the one to be begging the people that please come, it's enough, we want to give you state police. We are overripe for state police. And there is a misconception about the role of police.
Should this not be a constitutional matter?
Yes, it's a constitutional matter.
Should the National Assembly not be involved here?
Yes, but first of all, we must raise our voices. And we have been raising our voices. So I expect now that, we need to, whether a private member bill or people in the House of Assembly, we need to put pressure on our constituencies. It's for the good and for the prosperity of Nigeria. There is that fear that, for certain state police, no. You must understand that police is not about politics. The principal function of police is preservation of law and order, giving support services, enforcement of law, emergency responses. Sometimes when I drive on the Ikorodu Highway or when I go to Abuja, I see children, 4, 6 years, 7 years, trying to cross
the road,
6 lanes. The function of the policeman is to go there and assist them, take them to go, or sometimes you see a pregnant woman. Because there's no provision for physically challenged people. So they need to cross the highway, going to school. I wish I could stop and help them. That's the function of the police. To maintain law and order, to ensure that when people are fighting, you separate them, to protect the environment. Crime is just one function of the police. And, in Nigeria.
Crime busting.
Yes.
Crime busting.
Detecting crime and then prosecution and all. There are so many functions that, the police has. And since 1861, there was nothing done by Nigerian police. It grew out of our, desire to have,
Let me pause you a little. Tunde, hear what some antagonists of state police are saying. They're saying states that will hardly pay salaries would pay, can the states afford to pay the police? Is it a tame argument?
Well, I think the question we should ask them is that, can those people who are comfortable in that state live well if the state is not secure? Can you enjoy your money? Can anybody, any rich man from Abuja to Kaduna, drive a good car between Abuja and Kaduna nowadays, last 2 years? Can you do that without putting your hand on your chest? Now, the thing is that security is the very first thing. And people have to know that. The moment you grant state police, that is what we are talking about, restructuring. The federal government has to shed its powers. They devolve power to the states. When you devolve power, for instance, we are talking of solid minerals
now. Let's quickly go there. The last government of Muhammadu Buhari told us it is possible to remove power generation and transmission from the executive list to the concurrent list. It's gone.
He has done it, but what are you going to use to start electricity? To start railway, what resources is the state going to use? Let them allow each of the states, like we are talking about solid minerals now. Let each state, 36 states in Nigeria, let them control their solid minerals, 50% of their mineral resources. So that they can have money.
My state, for instance, Akwa Ibom, generates 101 megawatts of power from the Ibom power plant. That's somewhere at Ikorabasi, Wale. But when it empties what it generates
to the national level,
I don't know how much comes back to the state.
So that is why we are talking of devolution of power. That power has to be devolved. When you generate your power, you can only give it to the federal at your own level, not as a compulsion. Now it is a compulsion. When you generate power, you take it to the national transmission company. Transmission company will now distribute to.
But I'm saying states are now empowered to generate electricity.
And they are empowered, but the ways of generating is not spread out yet. We have a lot to do. Why is it that none of this?
So I have trouble with selling this idea of restructuring the country.
Well, the restructuring is about power devolution. When you have no power, when you have no resources, when you have no control over your resources, you have no power. Because resources
but,
is power.
Yeah, if you mean to restructure this country, Wale, yes. The National Assembly must be, they must buy into it.
Yes, we need to convince our legislators.
Who are we?
The representative issue the constituency. So our people need to be, we need to engage them constructively. And those who are opposed to it, we should not be angry with them. We need to engage them. We need to find out what are your fears. The negotiation that led to the end of apartheid, it was, you know, the white regime, apartheid regime, they told, you know, the ANC their fears. And, you know, they had to negotiate to reach a compromise. So we need to engage them because they also have, they are genuine fears that, look, are we not going to have a situation where the country will, you know, another. So well, it is our responsibility to have constructive engagement with them. That this idea, we, at the end of the day, after we have had it before, when we had regional autonomy. And why is it that when you go to North, East, West, everybody is talking about developments between 1950 and 1960 that we have not been able to equal. Look at University of Ife, look at ABU, look at UNN. No region has been able to build institutions
like that.
Look at the Western House, look at Cocoa House, look at the textile industry in the North. Look at Odua textile, built within a short period of 8 years. Now we have, since 1960 to this time, you know how many years? We have not been able to surpass the achievements of that era.
All right. Today, quickly, let's go here. We are talking about Afeniferi. Afeniferi is equal to Ohanaeze Ndigbo, is equal to Arewa Consultative Forum. Do you have implicit confidence and faith in them?
Well, I think your relevance is based on whether you are doing what your people want. The people of Afeniferi, we see the new leadership now. They have infused a lot of people there, with the intelligentsia, with the people who have business background. It is those people that make up that unit that will determine, that will cut the way forward. The North, the Arewa Consultative Forum, they know what they wanted. The Ohanaeze people know what they wanted. The Afeniferi people too know what they wanted. Let all these people come to a round table and negotiate.
Is it possible?
Well, we have no choice.
Wally, is it possible?
We have no choice.
It is possible.
We have no choice than to come around and negotiate and allay each other's fear, like he said. Allay each other's fear.
Because as we sit here, all of you and my humble self know that mutual suspicion, mutual mistrust and distrust are the orders of the day.
We can only solve that one by coming to the table and agree on what we want to do. Nobody must be ruling from behind. Do you know, I believe that because some people know they have the control of the military, they can say anything, anytime. And
Okay. I wish Afeniferi well. I wish it well. What about you?
What? I wish Afeniferi
well. The new blood. Okay. Do something.
The Minister of Police is a public officer for legal investigation and criminal emergency.
All right. Yes.
No state can do it. No federal government can do it alone.
Okay.
We need to involve the states.
Okay, then, we will apply the brakes here, but not before thanking the backroom boys and, of course, Wale Adeoye and Tunde Abato. I thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So that's it on the program for today and this week. You may watch a repeat broadcast of this particular episode tonight at 11. Join us on Sunday from 1:30 to 3:30 for an expanded version of Journalist Hangout. Now, we are also on YouTube at youtube.com/TVC.